First of all, we got our beautiful brothers and sisters right here, man. Where you guys are from?
Atlanta, Georgia. That's where we at right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was born from Chicago, so.
Okay.
I'm born from Cleveland, Ohio.
Oh, okay. Midwest in the house. Right. Okay, okay. Right. So what brought y'all to this headquarters that we are in front of right now?
So I was just talking to her, like, you know, I was going to see some monuments and whatnot. I was like, it would be dope to, you know, get more insight on, like, the Black Panthers and stuff, like Fred Hampton. She was like, just look up the address. I was like, all right, yeah, you want to go? She was like, yeah, I want to go. And we was like, I was 9 minutes away. We was like, bet. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I feel like it's got a little bit more purpose than seeing other monuments, just the natural city tourism, you know what I'm saying? But I was like, I want to do something that I'm connected to. And I feel like as a filmmaker, that's those type of stories that I be wanting to tell anyway. So yeah, I feel like the significance of Fred Hampton's legacy definitely should be highlighted, you know what I'm saying, to some degree.
I remember
to some degree. So I feel like they were on to something at that time. And feel connected to coming to Chicago. That's one of the things I know about Chicago. Why not come see it? So.
Yeah, I feel like that they were definitely on to something, and I feel like they tried very hard to stop it. And with so much energy and energy exerted into like stopping it, why not try to like pick it up and figure it out and try to reconnect in some way, shape, form, or fashion in 2023. You get what I'm saying? So it might not be the same exact way or the same mission that Fred was, but with the same purpose, you know? Like my partner said, my man is a film director, so he could tell a story and make it heartfelt. And it's unfortunate that they actually tore down where they assassinated this strong Black man.
So
yeah, they got a Walgreens. It was such a disgrace. So, it's unfortunate how they kind of like wipe us out in a way, or try to wipe our history away. So just find the pieces to connect the dots and make us embrace who we are, where we come from, and not only connect with the less fortunate creative aspects of the Black community, but the very powerful, impactful community that Black people have to offer.
Let me ask you this, brother, because you stated earlier that you're from this city, right?
Right.
How do you feel knowing internationally, not even nationally no more, but internationally, there's a narrative being painted that Chicago is death. Chicago is Chi-Rack. This is warland.
Yeah.
I'm sure you got a grandma that's from here that walks to the store, builds relationship with her neighbors. I'm sure you was a little boy learning how to ride your bike and fell and shared candy with friends.
Expect.
What's the misperception that the world is trying to paint about Chicago, but you know in your heart that's not what it is? Right. What is the reality at Chicago that you know?
Right. That's a good one. You know, when I came down here, I said the same thing. And since I haven't been down here in such a long time, I came to actually find some relatives and friends and family of my father, because my father was raised here for the most part, and he wanted to connect with the Black Panthers, but his family was kind of like, hey, chill, you know what I'm saying? So I felt like me coming here, I didn't feel that, you know what I'm saying? I was like, dang, like, they really paint that narrative as if it is, you know, Chi-Rack, but I feel like that's to a certain culture. You get what I'm saying?
That's everywhere.
I don't feel like, you know, where we stayed was in a nice condominium, you know what I'm saying? I know it wasn't Chi-Rack to them, you get what I'm saying? So that's why I decided to come through the neighborhood to, you know, try to fill it out for myself and go feel into my family and see what they were saying about the community and stuff like that, and where it started to turn, and ask her about, you know, like the GDs and the Gangsta Disciples and what that originally stood for before it got into, you know, turning into what it may be today, present day. And I could even see Fred Hampton picture in the window. I'm like, okay, so
So let me ask y'all this, man, on closing, man. What is this? Well, two questions on closing. What's the solution for our people? And as what we know as the Black Panthers, are we over or are we just getting right back restarted? We recharging. What's going on? Let us know what's going on.
The revolution would not be televised. I feel like it died down, but I feel like this generation is picking it back up. We're a lot more connected to purpose and finding community and taking action. I feel like we are tired and sick and tired and even more sick and tired of the BS. So I think we back in full effect. What was the other question?
Any solutions for our communities?
Solution is community and just creating and setting a standard, reading, educating yourself. Knowledge is power. I feel like, you know, so like underlooked. You know, like, we just look for answers or quick solutions, or we're always distracted. And we got to just take time aside and prioritize what's important and what can elevate life for our children and our future generations. So
yeah, I would say same thing. Solution would be, you know, us being out here right now. You get what I'm saying? Us taking the time to get to know each other and to build community. I think that's going to be like, that's why I thought it was so interesting to come see the house, because it's not like this is a humongous house. You get what I'm saying? So they started somewhere.
Yeah.
And it looks like they were able to do a lot just from this house and the block up the street. It was a lot that was able to be done. So I feel like that's very important to start in our communities, wherever we from, wherever we live.
Start small.
Yeah, start there, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, pay homage and tribute to your community in some shape or form, where you at, just by getting to know the people and what's needed.
To chatting with Champ for, you know, stopping us and asking these strong and powerful, impactful, thoughtful questions to allow us to just channel in and go in deeper.
Shout out to Chatting with Champ. He pulled up on us at the Black Panther headquarters to, you know, ask us some questions and deal with us. So, you know, shout out to him.
Well, I appreciate it.
Shout out to him for actually coming to check it out himself. So.
Yeah, yeah. And
very divine.
With the camera, you know what I'm saying? Just for real. Let's go.
Yes. Peace and love.